Like many growing cities, Amsterdam's electricity grid is under severe pressure. With low grid capacity struggling to meet increasing demand, late afternoon peaks see excessive electricity consumption, while midday in summer is often overloaded by surplus production from solar panels. Significant investment is needed to upgrade the infrastructure to meet these challenges.
Amsterdam is very much characterized by a city which is running towards the end of the capacity of the electricity grid. We talk about 400 million euro of investments. And the grid operator doesn't have the people, they don't have the material, and they don't have the time to upgrade this infrastructure. So they are in a high need of such flexibility solutions.
Flexibility that energy communities can provide.
An energy community is a collective of citizens that tries to deliver themselves energy services, but it's a collective of citizens that has some kind of self-rule.
There are nearly 700 energy communities in the Netherlands, and one of these is located in the Sporenburg district of Amsterdam's eastern Docklands. Here, 540 households contribute to the production of renewable energy with solar panels and heat pumps.
The energy communities here are actually quite big, and that is because the Dutch government at one point realized that the energy transition cannot be done without citizens. You need companies, you need the state itself, but you also need the citizens and citizens' collectives to reach your goals in the energy transition.
Committed citizens and the government's support were already in place. With the support of the European research project Reschool, the third pillar, a distribution system operator, came on board as well. This helps ensure the efficient delivery of self-generated renewable electricity to households in the Sporenburg energy community.
What we want people to do is to consume at the right moments. So to consume less when the grid is busy and to consume more when there's room on the grid. So how do we do that? That's where the app comes in. So the app tells you, hey, the grid is busy now, please reduce. Or hey, there's much room on the grid, use as much as you want.
The app is designed to encourage grid-conscious behavior and optimize power consumption. But how exactly can you change the way people use electricity?
We're using the software to real-time measure the energy consumption of individual residents. And at the same time, based on the congestion problems which we're forecasting on the network, we're sending people challenges. And these challenges are intended to request them to change their behavior on that moment in time. And for these challenges, they get actually paid.
Challenges such as these encourage grid-sensitive behavior, helping to prevent blackouts and reducing the need for expensive grid upgrades.
This is last Monday. There were two moments where we had grid congestion. And in those moments, I will receive a notification and a challenge. And if I join these challenges, I can earn points. And so if I change my power consumption and I earn the points, these points are actually even translated with an exchange rate into actual money.
This way, the app not only helps residents to save money and energy, but also empowers them to actively participate in the community's energy management.
We will increase our energy independence with the 500 households who live attached to this transformation house. We will show that the transformation house is good enough while having every time more electric vehicles and more solar.
Education and community engagement are crucial to achieving this. It is only by sharing information and technology that real change is possible.
Sharing information is needed to optimize energy consumption. So we really want to have an interactive process with the prosumer to create understanding, to show why you are participating and what difference it makes.
As the pressure on Amsterdam's grid continues to grow, the Sporenburg Energy Cooperative offers a sustainable, cost-effective and community-driven way forward. In this way, the costly replacement of transformer stations can be postponed. It's a blueprint for the future of energy management in other cities, and its smart app is already publicly available.
The results we would like to see in this project is that we can really create tools which are not too difficult for actually energy communities to apply them and use them in their own organization or their own situation.
Sporenburg proves that when citizens, technology and cooperation come together, sustainable energy is possible and everyone benefits.